Welcome to video 11 on the Yamaha Montage and Modiac synthesizers. In this video we are going to tweak a sound to our liking via the quick edit screen, and when we are done and we are happy, we save it in a user bank as a new performance. Let's set ourselves a goal and try to create a very dreamy, mellow, soft sound for slow playing. And well, maybe we can find a piano plus pad or plus strings as a starting point and tweak it from there. So let's go to category search, and well, this CFX plus pad 2 might be a nice starting point. Let's just have a look. The performance button brings us to the screen that tells us there are two parts in this sound. Well, let's have a listen. Yeah, piano plus a pad. That's okay. The designer of this sound apparently gave three knobs a function, these ones over here. So let's first have a listen what those do. This is the piano, and if we turn up this knob, we get a lot of reverb. Well, for the sound I intend to make, reverb on the piano is great. The third knob tunes in the pads, and well, they are a little bit wah-wah to my liking, so I like to change that a bit, but the idea is good. And let's keep that filter open. The middle button, look, the strings or pads are fast, and when I turn the knob they come in slow, so there is an attack time in there. All good, but not really what I would like to make. I like to make some alterations myself and then save this sound as a user sound, so that I don't have to tweak the knobs every time. I can just start playing with exactly what I want. So how can we tweak this sound? Well, we can go to quick edit via a motion control, the quick edit screen. There we can try to make some alterations, and what I would like to do is tone down the piano. The high frequency is cut off so that it is very soft but with a lot of reverb, and then increase the filter of the pad to make it more stringy. Let's try that out. What we see in the top right corner is that the current setting is common, and I want to tune only the piano, so I select part 1, which was the piano. Now all these functions, parameters, only work on part 1. What I like to do is make it a lot more mellow, so I'm going to tone down the cutoff. Yeah, that's good. And then I like to have a lot of reverb on it. Yeah, good. And the stereo, I like to have it a little bit more to the left. Well, that sounds to go in the direction I intended. Let's go to the pad. The pads are in part 2, so let me select part 2. Now all these functions work only for part 2. And what I like to do is have the cutoff a lot higher. I get more stringy sound. But it's a little bit too much wah-wah, so we can bring back the resonance to take that off. Yeah, this is going in the right direction. I like to have a little bit of attack, not too much, but just a little, and somewhat more release. So if I let go of the keys, it stays playing a while. And the panorama in the stereo view, we put it to the right a bit. And now let's try it out with everything going. That is quite okay. I think I like to store this sound as a new user sound. To save the sound, we simply press the store button. That brings us over here, and we can store as a new performance. And let's give it the name Dreamy. If that name already exists, that is not known, that the system doesn't say, but it's okay. Stored, completed, so let's have a look at category search if we can find our new sounds in the user bank. It should be there. Well, there it is, Dreamy, our new sound. Okay, let's have one more listen. I'm quite happy with it, and the plus is that we have saved it, and when we recall it, we don't have to tune any knobs, we immediately get this sound. In the next video, let's try to see how we can assign parameters to those rotating knobs ourselves.